We did discuss too much technical stuff yesterday. I want to keep this slightly informal today. And even if it looks like slightly casual at times also, because the idea is to share one's experience in terms of, you know, how life is not as simple as we think, or how things not necessarily go as per planning, and how you have to allow circumstances and situations to unfold and then do your own life score correct course correction. So with that, let's start. Umar, next slide. So I'll just quickly share my journey, just slowly. So continue. So if you see this chart is trying to show my journey in terms of how I have worked over the last 29 years. So if you see very carefully, I passed out engineering and electronics, being topper in university in 1989, which was 31 years back. Worked with CMC for about a year and got a job, or rather got selected for MMS at Jamnalal Bajaj. Now JBIMS even today has the lot of flair even in your generation, so you can understand how coveted that position was at that point in time. It only in hindsight we realized that out of the batch of 70 which got selected from 32,000 students who appeared at that point in time, there were only 14 or 15 of us who were from open category. But obviously you come to know these things later. So it was a kind of you know, a peak of achievements at that point in time, as if we have arrived in the world. Got placed in CRISIL, and the CRISIL that time was very different. It was a young organization of 1 year old, had just been constitutionalized, and ratings were made mandatory in 1991, which was our second year, when we had just moved into second year. So working in CRISIL 3 years was a great experience at that point in time. The next pinnacle of the job happened when I joined Jardine Fleming, which is now JP Morgan, and that was the largest FII working in India at that point in time. Life was going well, everything was doing fine, and you had 1990, the atomic, the event that India created, and because of that there was a sanction on India, and concurrently there was an Asian crisis going on. So I actually lost my job for 6 months. I was without a job, somehow landed up in a company called Anand Rathi, which today people love to join, but then nobody wanted to join, and worked there for about 4-5 months, 6 months, and got to work again with a very great brand called GE Capital at that point in time, where we were co-managing one of the largest funds in India again at that point in time. And as things took turn in 2000, you had the dot-com bubble and then the crash. The fund that we were managing at one time was $150 million at that point in time, which dropped to something like $9 million over a span of 9 months. So we've seen how bad things can go, and the arrangement which we were running with from GE Capital to the Edinburgh-based fund had to be closed. So I had to move on, joined Enam, which was one of the, and even today, one of the best places which people want to join when it comes to equities. Worked there for about 10 months, got an opportunity to work for Kotak Securities. And during those difficult times, I was actually joining a team which took the funds under management from 130 crores to 1400 crores over a span of 11 months. As destiny would have had it, I had a big fallout with the existing team at that point in time and was forced to move out of the business completely. And again, I was, kind of looking for opportunities at that point in time. Was there without an opportunity for 2-3 months. Fortunately, I got an opportunity to work with a group called Wellspun it was a kind of reboot to my career. Wellspun was a 300 crore company that time, was going through a lot of changes internally. Over the next 3 years, I worked in that company and actually unfolded or rather unlearned and relearned a lot of things, which today constitute a very important fabric of my professional offer. Wellspun moved from 300 crores to 3,000 crores during the time when I was working there, and I was working with the office of the executive director, who became the managing director by those 3 years. And in that role, I was basically bringing efficiency to the decision making of managing director's office. So you effectively have close to 10 or 12 functions reporting to the MD through you, which gave a completely different picture of the same things which I had learned till then. As destiny would have had it, I had a chance to come back to the markets and worked with two broken franchises which were trying to rebuild their franchise at that point in time, Dolat Capital and Almonds. Recreated those franchises where people today go and join these places. And within about 4 or 5 years, I got an opportunity to join SBI Funds Management as head of research for their entire research team, both debt as well as equity. 2014 onwards, I have moved to a separate vertical, which I have been driving, which is equities alternate investment funds, which are marketed to extreme high net worth individuals. And my typical ticket size is more than 2 CR. And who knows what next? So it's been, if you just see, maybe two clicks more. One more, yeah. So if you see, if you break these three, the first two show a lot of job changes, and the last one shows only one job. So this is a job where I've spent 9 years now. And generally that is about rebuilding and consolidation and looking at life afresh. Next. So I'm just trying to rebuild whatever you saw on a scale of time and, you know, what it means in terms... Wait, just here. So what does this represent? Just put it in the box, this blue line, what it looks like. So if you see, it looks like the Sensex chart, but... just to give a perspective, this is my cost to company, the way it moved over a period of time. And if you see, there are periods where nothing happened. There are periods when everything happened, and there are periods when everything moved out. So life is like that. If you ask me, being topper from Mumbai University in engineering, being amongst top five in Bajaj, and having started career in CRISIL, life should have been, you know, straightforward. And if I don't show this line and just show you that dotted line, it's a nice slanting upward line. Because, you know, life is okay, but life doesn't go in straight line. It goes in ups and downs, and that's what life is all about. So my whole contention here was to make everybody aware that nothing can be taken for granted, at the same on the good side as well as on the bad side. Things don't remain the same. They will keep changing. Next one. So, this is a typical job of an investment manager, the way we spend our time. And if you see, it's extremely chaotic. There are so many things. So either I am a superman or I am fooling myself if I am saying I am doing all these things. So what is my job? Maybe you can press one more tick. One more. So this, in a noisy day, our job is to try to pick the right signals. If you see, we all got daily NAVs, so effectively we get evaluated, compared, butchered or cajoled every day, literally. And most of the time we are on the receiving end, because we get compared with indices, and indices don't sleep, they don't take holidays, they don't fall ill. So you get compared with something which is active even when you are sleeping. So that's a very tricky job. At the same time, next. So as I said, it's a noisy, chaotic thing. At the same time, there is a different perspective to this whole affair. So if you see, it's calm and cognitive at the same time. So when there is so much happening around you, it's a field which builds cognitive abilities to look through what is coming to you with prism of using all these experiences. So I'll use a line which Warren Buffett says that, you know, whatever one needs to make money has been already taught in 6th, 7th and 8th standard. And we'll come to it towards the later half when we speak, you know, how easy it is in life to get sorted and how difficult it is to do the same. So if you see, the job involves looking long-term, remaining patient, remaining focused, separating a lot of noise and focusing on signal, and not getting deterred by whatever volatility you are subjected to. So if I see a market at 7,800, I should 7,300, I should not be worried, neither I should be excited. It needs a very different character. So next slide. So I'm just picking up stuff which I had learned from my basics and which helped me to orient my career to an extent. I'm not saying I'm a successful man, but I am an average individual who's managed to stay afloat in spite of all these difficulties, whatever I showed you. And most of it was due to the fact that I was willing to learn. And as I told you, my basic is in marketing. So whoever takes finance will enjoy my sessions for a very different reason. They are being taught by somebody who doesn't know it, which is a very, very interesting part of learning, because the way we look at it is, we don't have all the answers. We will seek it together. And that is a better way of learning, according to me. So if you see how finance says what is important in business, it says improving shareholders' wealth is important. And improving shareholders' wealth, you have to have a return on equity, which is profit after tax divided by the net worth on the business, is the most important ratio. Now, the beauty is, since I did marketing and I had actually, gone through every page of Kotler during doing marketing, believe me, I never looked at this chart, which is in first chapter itself at that point in time. And I'm sure many of you who are taking marketing would also miss it. Because we all decide that we are marketing guys and we are not supposed to learn so many things of finance, which is what is a myth I will try breaking as we go in the next few slides. The beauty here is in Prasanna Chandra's first chapter itself, it ends with a focus on profitability control. And it highlights that every action that a marketing team is supposed to take, they are supposed to measure return on net worth of every action that they are taking for each product. Next one. So, one more, yeah. So here I'm just trying to highlight that all of us feel that main marketing wala hu, main finance wala hu, main operations wala hu, main itna hi karunga, mere ko itna hi padhna hai, koi problem nahi hai. But as you go through your life, you start realize that business doesn't operate in silos. It has to take into account other disciplines, and which is what I'm trying to highlight here, that a customer and value proposition are as important things as finance and building capabilities in operations. And the ecosystem in general has to benefit everybody who is associated with the company. So whenever you look at any business, you are supposed to ideally see into it through your actions. How do you add value to each of these constituents? And which is where I have just kind of given a brief charts here, which show that every professional working in an organization has to be aware of what it's next. Just click one more. Piche. Yeah, sorry, then. Okay, move on. So every professional, next one. So when you plan a business, now this is where it becomes slightly more interesting. One more click. So there is a value for customer from where we start, and we create a value for the ecosystem. And these are 9 questions which each of us should ask, irrespective of our discipline. So even if you are a marketing guy, you are a finance guy, you are an operations guy, at every stage we are supposed to actually evaluate and take these calls daily basis. So if you are, if even one question is unanswered, your ecosystem will not be balanced and your profitability and your value creation will go for a toss. And the core with which we evaluate a business, which is the next tick, is that value added by company, which is what all of us call as market cap, is monetized representation of the of what it adds to its products or services in the eyes of its customer. So if the customer does not see value, which is where the arrow starts from, there will not be a value added in the ecosystem. But at the same time, every action that you will take in each of these boxes will have an impact in terms of costs on the other box. So if I say that I want to increase sales channel, it will mean extra cost. Now, whether the revenues come or not is a function of how efficiently that is being used, which will be seen only later. So many of the times, 90 to 95% of costs have to be put on block before even the first product is produced. Very quickly, just one explaining it to you in one example. If Maruti decides to launch a vehicle at 500,000 rupees, 5 लाख रुपए की व्हीकल अगर वो अनाउंस करते हैं तो वो 5 लाख रुपए की व्हीकल अनाउंस करते टाइम उन्होंने टारगेट मार्केट देखा हुआ है, कितनी गाड़ियां बिक सकती है वो देखा हुआ है, और वो बेचने के लिए जो जो मुझे कॉस्ट स्ट्रक्चर, जो भी मेरे को वैल्यू कॉन्फिगर करनी है, जो भी मेरे डीलरशिप्स है, प्लांट्स है, प्लांट का यूटिलाइजेशन है, सब कर पहले ही करके रखा हुआ है. तो पहली कार प्रोड्यूस होने के पहले ही वो 5 लाख पे अगर मैंने 15-25-50 हजार रुपए का प्रॉफिट टारगेट किया है तो उसमें से 4 लाख ऑलरेडी मैंने दाव पे लगा दिया. सो विच इज वेयर ईच ऑफ अस व्हेन वी आर गोइंग इन इनटू आवर लाइफ वी हैव टू टेक इनटू अकाउंट व्हाट कॉस्ट्स आवर एक्शंस विल इनकर एंड व्हाट वैल्यू डज आवर एफर्ट डिलीवर. बोथ दीज विल बी वैल्यूएबल पार्ट ऑफ हाउ इवेंचुअली यू विल गेट रिम. Next one. So if you see this, this is coming from Deloitte and this is part of their consultancy model. And if you have a chance to look at it, maybe you can have it a look at it at slightly later also. You realize that there are multiple ways by which you will increase shareholder value. And they all are interrelated. So you can't say that I will have a revenue growth and I will give up margin. You will have to also try doing it at better margin. While doing that revenue growth, you will have to take into account whether you are using your assets efficiently or not. And while you are doing them efficiently, you will also have to see to it that your operating costs don't go up. And while all this business is running nice, you are supposed to handle how the outside world looks at your company. So everything is equally important. And every action by any of these boxes can have a financial reaction on the other box. So to that extent, you can't stay isolated and say, ki boss, main marketing wala hu, main yahi karne wala. Incidentally, for the guys, whoever would be taking marketing, over the last 7-8 years, and this is courtesy how Hindustan Unilever kind of institutionalized this. Actually, I was lucky that I had done this work before even Hindustan Lever talked about it. We had done it actually in a small company like Wellspun. There is a concept called return on marketing investments, which evaluates the efficiency of every marketing initiative which has been taken. And while everybody says marketing is something where you go and sell, marketing is something where you create the market and then force a sale. So everything has a cost, and how you efficiently bring more revenues than and to bring higher revenues put lesser cost will define how different you are from others. And there is a context to whatever I'm talking, because eventually company ho ya insaan ho, ye cheeze change nahi hoti, and we'll realize it in the second half when we discuss these things. Next one. So what is the common thread that I have learned from whatever? So I'll very slowly go through one each. First is, nobody knows everything, but everyone knows something more. Every day will keep bringing something new, and there is enough to learn. Understanding business is a core professional faculty. So agar aap koi bhi professional level pe, even if you start at the bottom or in the middle or you grow to the top, you cannot say that this is my core competency. Understanding business will always remain professional faculty, which means कोई भी धंधे में आपको ये समझ में आना चाहिए कि पैसा कैसे बन रहा है, कहाँ बन रहा है और क्यों बन रहा है. All businesses are selfish because सब लोग सबको पैसा बनाना है. Finance is bit more. Don't try to be a white crow. There are so many practices which have got entrenched into each business. Don't try to be the honest guy who is trying to change the system beyond a point. You will change it over a period of time when you create more of you in a system over a period of time, but it is too early generally to try questioning the system. Don't operate in a silo, as I discussed. Understand the whole. And for everybody who gets fascinated by the world of investments and equity research, finance doesn't mean just equity research. There is so much value which gets added within finance, outside equity research also. Equity research is more like the business which is under higher glare. So I use this syllable that every business which pays you more will always force you to look at, or rather will force you for some compromises which will be against your thread. Now, if you are comfortable with it, go ahead. If you are not comfortable with it, it will not be the field for you. And last but not the least, why slog for others? अगर आप दिन के 14 घंटे काम कर रहे हो और किसी और को पैसा कमा के दे रहे हो तो वही चीज आप खुद के लिए क्यों नहीं कर सकते? So this, according to me, is a very important perspective. As I said, after 30 years, obviously हम लोगों को ये सब समझ में आने में टाइम लगा. We all belong to a generation जहाँ पे I always say that for the essentials like तेल, दूध, राशन, पानी, गेहूं, चावल, शक्कर, इन चीजों के लिए हम लोग 5:30 बजे सुबह से क्यू में रहते थे. वहां से टू अ जनरेशन वेयर स्टूडेंट्स यूजिंग आईपैड एंड लैपटॉप्स सो अर्ली इन लाइफ, वी हैव कम टू फार. सो डेफिनेटली यू नो द वे यू अप्रोच लाइफ विल बी डिफरेंट. व्हाट आर द कोर ट्रेट्स व्हिच आई थिंक स्टिल हेल्प मी? And I repeat, I am not something I'm not somebody who is a star performer or a achiever or whatever. As I said, I have survived in a difficult field, and I think that's at times resurrection from near decimation itself is an achievement, and I look at life that like that. My focus has been learning and not just studying, and I thank for all those experiences which I shared with you where there have been intermittent lapses in the trajectory which I was moving in and which forced me to go back. So it is like a saap seedhi, you know, ki aap do seedhi mile, khush ho gaye, 63 pe pahunch gaye, aur fir teen paase pe teen gir ke 66 se wapas 13 pe aa gaye, wapas zor se kaam chalu kar diya, sab karte 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 92 pe aa gaye. 92 mein aap khush the ki abhi do teen paason mein aapka life paar ho jayega. आपके पासे में 6 आ गया, 98 का अजगर आपको निगल के 2 पे लेके आ गया, आपकी जिंदगी फिर शुरू हो गई. सो लाइफ विल फोर्स यू थ्रू दोज एक्सपीरियंसेस, बी रेडी फॉर देम. नथिंग इज परमानेंट, द ओनली थिंग व्हिच रिमेन्स कांस्टेंट इन लाइफ इज चेंज. बी रेडी फॉर सरप्राइजेस, गुड, बैड, अगली, व्हिचएवर दे विल बी, बिकॉज यू डोंट कंट्रोल द आउटकम्स, यू कंट्रोल योर एफर्ट एंड यू कंट्रोल योर इंटेंट एंड इंटेंसिटी. Carry experiences and not snapshots, so which is where my this first line where I'm saying, if you go to any place of pilgrimage, you don't take photographs beyond a point. You want to actually soak in that environment and go closer to the source, the God, to understand the reason why you exist. And I think that's what these experiences mean. Only intellect is not enough. To invest in our other quotients, I will discuss them sometime later. Invest in yourself, keep prepare, keep working and wait for the opportunity. Now, a lot of guys call this luck. Now, using again line of Satya Nadella, luck is when preparation meets opportunity. And the only thing that is in your control is to keep preparing and keep working towards seeking opportunities. Life is an opportunity creating machine. You have to be aware and you have to be prepared. Both are in your hands. Find your strengths, deepen them. So a lot of the time people tell you by strengths, weaknesses, work on your weakness, improve them. I have learned it the hard way. It's like cricket. If you are a very good batsman, you need not bowl, right? If you are a very good bowler, you need not have a great batting. But at the same time, whatever are your weaknesses, if you have to rate them on a scale of a to, or rather scale on one being the best and five being the worst, everything where you think you are weak, you should be at least 3 or 4. But everything where you think you are the best, you should be at 1. Then nobody touches you. So keep that as a focus. Very few people talk about this. Very few people say, boss, ye to mera strength hai, but mereko mera weaknesses cover karna hai. Be very clear. Life is not all about optimization. Life is all about maximization. If you maximize what you are good at, people will accept you with your weaknesses. And that's very important. And don't seek acceptance. Just seek excellence. Over a period, it will get rewarded. Next, just click one more. One more. Yeah. Just one more. So, a lot of guys say experience, and sometimes experience becomes a baggage. But the way I have learned it is, experience is all about mistakes. We should do as less of them. Wait, now. Abhi der apan rukenge. So experience is all that you have done as mistakes in your life. The key is to do less of them, learn from them, and don't repeat them. With this, I will just stop and then take some questions and then we start our journey for the next one. Is that fine, Omar?
Yes, sir. So if there are any questions, please raise your hand and ask those questions. There is one question that has come on the chat, but I guess it's just asking about how do you, being from a marketing background, get into the scope of equity research. You can choose to answer that later, maybe if you want.
Yeah, no problem.
Any questions? Somebody had raised hand in between. Sweetie Vora, you had raised your hands. If there's a question, please ask.
No, sir, that was by mistake. Sorry, sir.
Okay, no issue. Any questions, anybody, please raise before we move on to.
Hello. Yeah. So you have spoken about IQ is not enough, invest in EQ. So if you can tell a little bit about it.
Yeah, it will. It's all there okay. In the presentation. We have just kind of taken a pause because koi so gaya to fir samajh mein aa jata hai. Umar ne proctors lagaye sabke computers mein. Kisi ko pata nahi hai.
Yes, any other questions, please? Anybody? Okay, sir, we'll go ahead then.
So when there are no questions, there are only two possibilities. One is either everybody has had everything or everybody has kind of, achha, theek hai, chalo, aage chalo. So I assume it is the first and it's an excellence of a speaker which has caused it. Aisa soch ke apan aage ka chalo.
Let's be optimistic.
Yeah. So, before we start, I want in the chat box, please write why you are in this course. Why are we doing this MBA course? And be very honest, brutally honest to yourself. Because that's something which we all have to learn as early in life as possible. Just be brutally honest to yourself.
Okay, guys, come on. Quickly mention the reasons why you have enrolled for an MBA program. Come on, whatever be your answer, it's fine. There's nothing right or wrong about it. Whatever be your answers.
So, jo soye hoenge, wo bhi samajh mein aa jayenge na tere ko.
Yes, why have you enrolled in for an MBA program? Come on, guys, hurry up fast. better career opportunity. Want to work skills. And gain more skills, moving ahead in my career and a better salary. Somebody's being honest.
Yeah.
Earn more money, career shift. Okay. Fulfill dad's dream. IT to marketing. Earn money. Boost profile. Chances of promotion. Business. Business development skills. So I guess earn more money is,
yeah, so I'm happy.
A very strong one. And yeah. Somebody mentioned fulfilling dreams of their parents as well as breaking the glass ceiling.
Very good. Chalo. So we are on track. Yeah. So we'll go to the our slides again.
Yeah, I'll share that again.
Yeah, so just wait, huh? Just click once, bus. So wait. So all of you have looked at MBA as an opportunity. If just to give you a perspective, MBA was started to nurture entrepreneurs and to create a society. Go on. Create a society where people will be enterprising. They'll create businesses. They will balance commerce and improve society. But currently, we are all happy crop working as Taiwalas. And as the industry looks at us, we are much below average. And in our markets, they all call mane baddu avde chhe. Mujhe sab achcha lagta hai. And as you all correctly highlighted here, if you see, I'm happy that there is a brutal honesty to quite a few of you. We are all here to make money, right? तो अगर पैसा बनाना है तो अपन उसी पे फोकस करते हैं कि पैसा कैसे बनेगा. फाइन. सो आई विल शेयर समथिंग फ्रॉम वॉट एवर आई हैव सीन अराउंड मी एंड वॉट एवर आई हैव सीन इन लाइफ एंड वॉट एवर आई हैव लर्न फ्रॉम लाइफ. या नेक्स्ट वन. सो आई एम जस्ट वेट. हाँ. सो इफ यू सी दीज आर द फोर फंड मैनेजर्स. First one is Prashant Jain from HDFC Mutual Fund. Second one is Nilesh Shah from Kotak. Third one is Mr. Naren from Prudential. Fourth one is my boss, Navneet Munot from SBI. Now, what is, these guys get paid more than 5 CR per annum. How much? 5 CR per annum. Why do they get paid so much? As I have written here, we are interested in hard-earned money of a lot of people. There is a fiduciary responsibility which has been given by the trust which these guys have put in us. And our job is to look at that money with a very calm mind and try putting it in opportunities where it will meet the targeted returns that every individual is seeking from it. Yeah, next. Continue. Wait. So if you see, it requires to remain equanimous with good and bad. Stay away from all material lures. Now, each of these guys is managing. So just to give you a perspective, in SBI MF today, we manage 11 lakh crore as of yesterday. So yesterday we crossed 4 lakh crores on our mutual fund business. We manage around 700,000 crores of government EPF money. So we are the largest today in India with 11 lakh crores. And the other three together are managing another 11 lakh crores. So this, ye char log milke 22 lakh crore manage kar rahe hain. To inko ye paisa manage karte time, so many lures must be there, no? Ki boss, paisa hai aakhir. So they have to be equanimous. Ki bhai, kuch bhi ho, mera kaam hai, ye paise ke prati jo mere pe trust diya hua hai, us trust ko nibha ke, jo returns mere investors seek kar rahe hain, वो इनको देने का. एट द सेम टाइम देयर इज अनदर वे टू लुक एट मनी. नेक्स्ट वन. अदर्स मनी वर्सेस माय मनी. यू एवरीबॉडी विल नो दिस गाय, राइट? इट्स द ही इज द पोस्टर बॉय ऑफ वेल्थ इन दिस जनरेशन टुडे. व्हाट डज ही डू? या नेक्स्ट. सो ही इज मैनेज्ड. वेट he's managed to balance the trinity of money, fame and power. तो जिंदगी में आप कभी भी कोई भी चीज में जब भी कूदोगे इसमें से एक चीज आपको बहुत मायने रखेगी. I would like to warn each of you that all three together is very bad. Just one of them is best. One and a half is better than the best. But two is where the life's disaster starts, because then the third automatically comes, whichever it is. And when all the three come, each of your minutest action is up for public scrutiny. And then you become answerable to the whole world for whatever you do, which is not necessary beyond a point in life. So you should be clear of where to stop and where to say, okay, this is good enough for me. From here on, whatever I do will not have money as a very or a very important parameter, and start sharing some of it with the society. Next one. Making a crore is very simple, right? Start with 1,000 rupees, make it 10x, 4 times every time. These are the three individuals who have done it. The first one is Rakesh, who everybody knows. Second one is Nimesh Bhai from Inam, who also everybody knows. And third one is already a rock star now. He was used to work very silently, but today is relatively more open to fame. Mr. R.K. Damani, the owner of DMart, whose core competence is actually identifying value companies early in life. Having created one, he even now has a very rare track record of creating wealth from everything that he... So he's like a Midas. So, अपने को जिंदगी में ऐसा बनने का कोशिश करना चाहिए अगर आपको पैसे ही और या जिंदगी में कुछ बनना ही है. When people come to you for money, for benefits or even rewards, whichever way you want to look at it. The next one. So I'll spend some time I'll spend some time here. This is a very important slide, and the sooner all of you wake up to this, the better. This is from the book Rich Dad Poor Dad by Kiyosaki. It highlights that there are 4 levels of individuals when it comes to wealth. The first one is the employee quadrant. Second one, which is on the left hand side bottom, is the self-employed quadrant. The next one is the business owner, and the third one is investor. Now, if you look at the vertical line itself, the vertical lines separates how the income is going to be earned. So on the left side, it's called linear income. Continue. So where money will grow linearly, money is directly proportional to time. Wait. Money pays bills and time is not your own. तो आप अगर अवेलेबल नहीं हो तो पैसा नहीं आएगा. इस वक्त बहुत सी दुनिया यहां पे फंसी हुई है. आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर रियलाइजिंग, एंड इफ यू गो थ्रू योर ओन आंसर्स विच यू गेव एंड गो थ्रू वन मोर लेयर ऑफ दैट आंसर, यू आर स्टिल इन अ माइंडसेट ऑफ द लेफ्ट साइड. लेट्स सी व्हाट इज द राइट हैंड साइड. या राइट हैंड साइड इज कॉल्ड रेसिडुअल इनकम, which means you are leveraging time, you are creating more continuous income, your money works for you, you create big wealth, and your time is free. So every new time you get, you will put onto something new, which where the money will go and money will keep working for you. So you're sleeping, your money is working for you. So what is different in the income quadrant, which all of us, and I also to an extent would blame myself to have been a trap of this too early in life, but that was a different era where being an employee was looked after as a very important thing. But let me move on and highlight what I'm trying to say here. You think your monthly income is bringing you stability, but actually you're working for somebody else, and that somebody else is deciding what you deserve. And he will decide whether you will earn it tomorrow or not. This is the highest risk quadrant. Please understand, this is a highest risk quadrant. As you improve in your own abilities with experience, knowledge, skill sets, you will move down towards being self-employed. So these are typically the guys like lawyers, chartered accountants, doctors, specialists. But इसमें भी problem वही है कि वो छुट्टी पे चला गया, clinic बंद, right? या आपकी practice बंद. So you will have to, there is a limitation to which you can grow in on the left side. On the right side, what you do is you create, you take an idea, you invest your capital, you invest some time, and you assign and engage people on the left-hand side, which is the employee or the self-employed guys, and put them into a system where the business starts earning profits and you increase your wealth. And you will keep doing this over a 3-4 businesses. Each business will require some of your time. But here you will not be time rich. You will still have to keep investing your time into the business that you will develop. The last one is a classic one. And I'm lucky that I'm in the employee bracket where my job is that of being an investor. And as I said, because we are on a trusteeship role, the reimbursements are also good enough to remain. But frankly, if we use those skills for our own, we might actually make much bigger money. Again, we are all slaves of that monthly cash flows which come in the end. So let me spend some time on this. When you are an investor, what you will do? Anybody? Just put in the chat box. What will an investor do? Nobody? Yeah? Yeah?
Yeah, Shweta.
Yeah, I'm reading here.
Okay.
So some of you have got some things right. But that's where we'll have to change the way we all of us think. Just think simple. It's very easy to make things complicated and use jargons that we have learned. But if we have learned our basics correctly, we should be able to explain it simplistically. And how do I define simplicity? I'm sure some of your seniors who did my classes last year will remember this. Simplicity is the ability with which you can explain any concept to your younger sister, your mother, or your wife. So if you can do that, you have understood the concept. Otherwise, you can't. So try doing this for every concept that you learn. If try to be slightly more simple. So what did I say? The first guys are the guys whose destiny is decided by somebody else. Second guys are the guys whose destiny is in their hands, but their time decides what will be in their destiny. The third one is the guy who says, I will take the level one and level two guys and put them at work. The investor says, boss, mere paas 10,000 rupiah hai aaj ki tarikh mein. 1,700 rupiah mein Shambhani ko deta hoon. Woh 16 ghante kaam karega mere liye. 600 rupiah mein Bharti ko deta hoon. Woh 16 ghanta kaam karega mere liye. 2,000 rupiah mein हिंदुस्तान लीवर को दे देता हूँ, वो लोग काम करेंगे, इतनी बड़ी फौज है. द आइडिया इज टू इन्वेस्ट इन बिजनेसेस वेयर द बिजनेस ओनर्स विल वर्क फॉर यू एंड द मनी विल कीप ग्रोइंग. नाउ दिस इज द निर्वाणा व्हिच ऑल ऑफ अस शुड सीक ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. सो इट्स नॉट इजी टू ब्रेक आउट ऑफ योर एग्जिस्टिंग क्वाड्रेंट्स, बट योर फोकस शुड बी टू मूव टुवर्ड्स इन्वेस्टर क्वाड्रेंट एज सून एज पॉसिबल. Because then you will create your financial independence and you will start looking at life in terms of what you really want to do, on which we'll spend some time as we go forward. Fine, next. I hope you guys like this as a concept because this is very important. Ek ek karke ja, ruk, piche ja. Ek bas. So this is again, you won't find it this in any book. So these I call four truths of life, and they work in every contour of life wherever you go. So the first one, which is brutal and which is what has caused all of us to actually stay at home, is death. And death has a negative connotation, so let's use the positive connotation called breath. तो जिंदगी तब तक चालू है जब तक सांसें चालू है. और जिंदगी अपन जब भी पैदा हुए उस वक्त डिफाइन लम्हों से नहीं कर की गई है या टाइम से नहीं की गई है, वो नंबर ऑफ ब्रेथ से कर दी गई है. एंड दिस इज बीन रिटन बाय ऑल द फेथ बुक्स फ्रॉम द गीता टू बाइबल टू कुरान टू ग्रंथ साहब. इवेंचुअली यू हैव कम ऑन दिस अर्थ विथ डिफाइंड नंबर ऑफ ब्रेथ्स. तो क्या करने का लाइफ में, लंबी सांसें लेने का, ज्यादा टाइम जिंदा रहना है ना. हाँ, सो लंबी सांसें लेने का नंबर वन. नंबर टू, द मोस्ट ब्रूटल फोर्स ऑन अर्थ इज ग्रेविटी. किसी भी चीज को ऊपर जाने के लिए वक्त लगता है और पुश लगता है. कोई भी जोर से अगर ऊपर जा रही है और जल्दी जा रही है तो जब भी वो गिरना चालू होती है तभी ग्रेविटी का फोर्स और बड़ा होता है. और अपनी जिंदगी में ग्रेविटी क्या है, अपनी जिंदगी की सबसे बड़ी ग्रेविटी है इन्फ्लेशन. सो व्हाट यू अर्न टुडे इज मोर वैल्यूएबल देन व्हाट यू अर्न टुमारो, राइट. सो इन्फ्लेशन इज द ग्रेविटी विच इज रिड्यूसिंग द ट्रू वैल्यू ऑफ योर इनकम. सो विच इज व्हाई आवर फोकस शुड बी टू कीप अर्निंग सो मच मोर देन द इनकम दैट एट सम स्टेज इन्फ्लेशन बिकम्स यू नो अ नॉन इवेंट फॉर यू. थर्ड वन इज मनी. नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू मी मनी इज मटीरियल प्रेजेंस ऑफ गॉड. भगवान हर घर नहीं जा सकता है इसलिए वो माँ बन के जाता है एंड और पैसा बन के जाता है. इट्स द हार्ड ट्रूथ ऑफ लाइफ. अगर आपके पास पैसा नहीं है तो आपको माँ बाप भी नहीं पूछेंगे. एंड यू सम ऑफ यू विल रियलाइज इट, सम ऑफ यू मस्ट बी रियलाइजिंग इट. मनी इज एक्सट्रीमली इंपॉर्टेंट. द पीरियड दैट वी आर गोइंग थ्रू is even making it, making everybody realize, and we saw those two curves yesterday, that the more you try saving lives, the more the country gets fucked. So there is a balance, and which means money is important, and sometimes as important as life. But, kyunki aaj ki tarikh mein agar aapke paas paisa nahi hai, toh aapko bed bhi nahi mil raha hai. Aur paisa hai toh bhi nahi mil raha hai. So both these truths are important. So, It's extremely vital that we respect this truth. पैसा क्या जरूरी नहीं है, पैसे से कुछ नहीं होता है, पैसा सब कुछ नहीं है, ये सब चीजें कभी कहने की. When you have earned it, Mercedes में बैठ के रहोगे या साइकिल के बैठ के रहोगे, it's your choice, right? A monk who sold his Ferrari will happen only after you aim the Ferrari, you work for the Ferrari, you have the Ferrari. रगड़ के इस्तेमाल करके ठोक ठोक के एंजॉय करने के बाद उसको बेचोगे तभी आप मॉन्क बनोगे. बट देयर इज नो हार्म इन कीपिंग दैट एज अ फोकस दैट आई वांट टू अर्न दैट फरारी फर्स्ट. देन यू रियलाइज रिलेवेंस ऑफ मनी एंड प्रोबेबली एट टाइम्स इवन द लिमिट टू विच इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट इन लाइफ. बियॉन्ड दैट यू विल एक्चुअली स्टार्ट शेयरिंग इट. लास्ट बट नॉट द लीस्ट, डेस्टिनी. सो एज आई सेड, मतलब आई विल यूज ओनली वन लाइन, वक्त के पहले और किस्मत से ज्यादा कुछ भी उखाड़ो नहीं मिलने वाला है. बट दैट डजंट मीन द नेक्स्ट वन, दैट डजंट मीन यू हैव टू कॉम्प्रोमाइज विथ योर कर्मा. तो अपना काम करते रहो, एज आई सेड, कीप वर्किंग ऑन योर सेल्फ, रिमेन प्रिपेयर्ड एंड रिमेन अवेयर फॉर दोज अपॉर्चुनिटीज विच गॉड विल कीप थ्रोइंग एट यू. Don't blame him later for not having done anything like that, because you were not prepared. Fine. Next one. तो यहाँ पे मैं एक छोटा सा detour ले रहा हूँ to make all of us aware कि we are human beings are the most evolved, continue evolved out of the 250 million species which exist. तो amoeba से अपनी journey शुरू हुई, अभी अपन इंसान करके घूम रहे हैं. So अपने को ना दो चीजें भगवान ने, तीन चीजें अलग दी है जो बाकी लोगों को नहीं है, बाकी एनिमल्स में नहीं है. तो पहला अपने को हार्ट दिया है जो मोस्ट रिफाइंड है, चार कंपार्टमेंट वाला है. दूसरा अपने को ब्रेन दिया है जो मोस्ट इवॉल्व्ड है. और तीसरा अपने को गट दिया है, माइंड दिया है, जो अपने को बार बार बताते रहता है. तो सक्सेस नाउ फॉर मैन, इफ गॉड हैज क्रिएटेड अस एज द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट, जस्ट वेट हियर, दैट्स द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट. वन मोर, एक और क्लिक मार, एज बस. सो इफ ही हैज क्रिएटेड अस इज मोस्ट यूनिशियस सक्सेस उसने अपने लिए लिख के रखा है. लेकिन अपने साथ प्रॉब्लम क्या हुआ कि अपने पूरे इवोल्यूशन प्रोसेस में वीव इवॉल्व थ्रू डिफिकल्टीज. सो देर आर ओनली टू ऑप्शन which were there at one point in time. One was fight, which is success. Another was flight, which is survivor. Bhag jao. So human mind jo hai na, wo aisa programmed hai ki the easiest option is flight. To apne ko kabhi bhi koi bhi musibat aayegi, to your first response is always of survival. To aise time pe shanti se teen saanse lena, apne aap ko question puchna, is this fatal for me? Main isme marne wala hu kya? Nahi na. आगे चलो, गो विथ अ डिफरेंट माइंडसेट, यू विल सडनली रियलाइज इट्स ऑल इन द माइंड. नेक्स्ट. तो अपने को दिन में 80,000 थॉट्स आते हैं दोस्त, ओके, और दे वो सब सेम होते हैं, कल आए वही, आज आए वही, कल है. एंड लॉट ऑफ देम हैव यू नो अफर्मेशंस विच आर बायस्ड विथ आर एक्सपीरियंसेस. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज लॉट ऑफ दिस हैव बीन क्रिएटेड ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. कि अपनी जो सिस्टम है, अपना जो हार्डवेयर है, अपना जो सिस्टम के अंदर ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम है, इट हैज गॉन थ्रू वेरियस वर्जन्स ऑफ आवरसेल्व्स. सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एट सम स्टेज टू कीप क्वेश्चनिंग व्हाट ट्रिगर्स योर इमोशंस, व्हाट ट्रिगर्स योर थॉट्स, हाउ दोज थॉट्स हैव गॉन इनटू बिलीव्स, एंड यू हैव टू ब्रेक आउट ऑफ इट टू री इन्वेंट योर सेल्फ फॉर अ बेटर रिस्पॉन्स सिस्टम. नेक्स्ट वन. So this is very important that, you know, our experiences create our feelings, our thoughts. Our thoughts create our feelings create our beliefs create our habits create ourselves, the way we look at ourselves and the way world look at us, and it creates our own life experience. So a lot of us will go through same experience again and again, again and again. So you have to reprogram yourself at some stage to come out of those patterns. Because those patterns are what you are subjecting your life to with a way you are thinking. And how does one do it? Next one. The biggest differentiator is mindset. So the left, you know, here I'll just spend 2 minutes more. So, duniya mein na char tarah ke mindset ke log hai. Ek hai jo scarcity mindset se aate hai, dusre jo survival mindset se aate hai. तीसरा है जो सक्सेस माइंडसेट है, चौथा है जो सिग्निफिकेंस माइंडसेट है. स्केयरसिटी मतलब क्या कि भाई मेरे को कुछ आया, उसमें मेरा खुद का जो भी मेरा खुद का खर्चा पानी हो गया, बस हाथ में कुछ नहीं. सर्वाइवल वाले हैं जो बोलते हैं कि भाई मेरे लिए है थोड़ा सा, यू नो, मेरे फैमिली के लिए है, दैट्स ऑल. तीसरे वाले जो है वो बोलते हैं मेरे पास, मेरे लिए है, फैमिली के लिए है, और मैं थोड़ी बहुत मजा भी करता हूँ. चौथे जो है वो बोलते हैं कि मेरे लिए है, मेरे फैमिली के लिए है, सोसाइटी के लिए है, और मेरा हर बार ये फोकस रहेगा कि आई क्रिएट समथिंग एंड मेक अ डिफरेंस टू द वे द वर्ल्ड इज ऑपरेटिंग. एंड इफ यू सी मोस्ट ऑफ द इनोवेशंस, मोस्ट ऑफ द मनी इज कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड टू दिस बास्केट. सो अपने को लाइफ में ना इस माइंडसेट के साथ प्रॉब्लम्स को हैंडल करना है. एंड विच इज वेयर आई हैव गिवन दिस चार्ट, स्पेंड सम टाइम ऑन दिस. This will make you aware of how your own response system is. So, अपने को कभी भी कोई भी problem आया तो अपना पहला कौन सा button दबता है और अपना पहला response preparation क्या रहता है, will let you know where you are on this, in this quadrant. And over a period, all of us should aim to go into the fourth one. Right? Next one. So, this is a concept which is slightly bas rukru. So with, if you see, this concept comes from a concept called ikigai, which is a Japanese concept, which says the sooner you realize purpose of your life. See, some of you might find this very philosophical. Believe me, 30 साल जिंदगी के लगने के बाद, बंबू लगने के बाद, ये सब चीजें मेरे को सूझती है. तो आपको लाइफ में मैं पहले ही देके रख रहा हूँ ताकि हर एक्सपीरियंस को आप इन फॉर्मेट्स में डाल के क्वेश्चन पूछो खुद को, तो आपको आपकी जर्नी आसान हो जाएगी. सो योर जॉब इज टू फाइंड द पर्पस फॉर विच यू हैव अराइव्ड ऑन दिस अर्थ. एज आई सेड, गॉड हैज अमंग्स द इवॉल्व्ड स्पीशीज, ही हैज गिवन यू ब्रेन, ही हैज गिवन यू माइंड, ही हैज गिवन यू हार्ट. यूज इट टू मेक अ डिफरेंस टू वेयर, टू द वर्ल्ड इन विच यू आर ट्राइंग टू लिव. यू कैन स्टार्ट टुडे, इट मे नॉट हैपन टुमारो, इट विल हैपन ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. किसी का ये चालू है, स्पीकर चालू है मेरे ख्याल से. So a lot of you would have played the Lagori in life, right? So let's see what's the Lagori of life. तो अपने को ये सातों चीजें लाइन में रखनी है तो अपनी जिंदगी पूरी होगी. And this success also means not just for me, it's something which you will do for everybody around you, which also means people who are not in your current contours themselves. Next one. So, yeah, just wait. Ye pura kar le, left wala. Yeah. So if you just go through, apne ko sabko paisa banana hai. But paisa kaise banega yaar? Somebody has to pay for it, right? So it would be either your employer or your client if you are in your own business. So all these questions, and if you go back, these are questions very similar to what we ask people looking at a business. If you guys are aware and are listening carefully, you will realize many of these questions we asked when we were looking for the understanding the business. And this, there is no difference between how a business is positioning itself vis-a-vis how we have to position ourselves in life. And which is where positioning yourself is equally important than just being good and being relevant, which is where the next chart will come. So there are 5 layers of career. Yeah. So if you see this, अपने को जिंदगी में ऊपर पहुंचना है दोस्त. सो वो कैसे होगा? सो विच इज वेयर ऑल दिस विल हैपन इफ यू हैव अ राइट माइंडसेट, एंड विच इज वेयर योर दैट लगोरी विच वी डिस्कस्ड इज वेरी क्लियर कि मेरे को करना क्या है, कैसे करना है और मैं वहां तक कैसे पहुंचूंगा. इसके लिए आपको अपना माइंडसेट प्रिपेयर करना पड़ेगा. एंड ऑल दिस इफ यू सी, इफ यू डोंट पजेस दोज वैल्यूज इन योर सेल्फ, cannot offer it to the world. And till the time the world doesn't realize that offer, people will not pay. And lot of the problem is about people being just aware also at times whether that offer is on. So which is where every finance guy has to understand marketing and every marketing guy has to understand finance. Because if your pricing goes wrong, you will go in the bottom bucket. You have to get your price right, for which you have to get your value right. People do pay wherever there is an access to value. So be valuable, invest in yourself and position yourself correctly. Next one. And if you, wait, piche ja. So if you see very carefully, the non-professionals, if they are earning X, the big guys are already earning 100X. And the situation that all of us are subjected to, the guys who are in this bottom two buckets and the ones which we discussed in the previous mindset basket on the top half of that matrix are at highest risk today. So the more and earlier you push yourself in the upper bracket, the better. Yeah. So how do you create that value? So you will create that value by having your own framework in terms of improving yourself. And this is a small slide which maybe you can spend some time later, and if anybody has question you can come back to me. Next one, isi mein next one dal dena. So each of them has a lot of things. So a lot of us spend time to invest in skill sets. Good skill sets with bad mindset is failure. So get your mindset correct. Be in a growth mindset than a survival mindset. Be in a victor mindset than victim mindset. Be a leader than follower. And be strategic than tactical. Similarly on skill sets, you have to seek each of them as you progress over a period of time. Some of them will be horizontal expertise, some of them will be vertical expertise. Value systems, this is something that you will evolve over a period of time, but you will realize the world sees you as you behave. So if you're very clear about what is non-negotiable, what is adaptable, what is flexible in your approach in terms of And remaining consistent at positioning is very crucial. And last but not the least, if you are very weak on execution, God bless you. Because mindset, skill sets and values without execution is failure. So you be very clear that be massive on action, be clear on decision and take extreme ownership of outcome. आप अगर रस्ते खड़े तो जनरल आर्ग्यूमेंट अपना ह्यूमन माइंडसेट का रहता है कि भाई मेरे को उसने उड़ा दिया. द एक्सट्रीम ओनरशिप मींस यू आर इन्वेस्टिंग इन योर एबिलिटीज एंड अवेयरनेस टू सच अ लेवल दैट यू आर रेडी इवन फॉर दैट आउटकम टू बी अवॉइडेड एंड बी डीप इन योर कमिटमेंट्स. अनलेस यू आर इन इन दीज फोर जोन्स, all the first three are useless. Next one.
Sir, can I interrupt for a moment? For all yes. those who have been watching, this is one of the finest slides I've seen for a very long time, sir. This is amazing. अगर आपकी permission हो तो later हम लोग इसको थोड़ा borrow कर सकते हैं, because ये बहुत जबरदस्त slide है.
ये अपने बीच में ही रखो सर. मतलब बाद में आप use करो, क्योंकि सभी आपका ही
है. नहीं सर, I am very 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 impressed with this slide. This is absolutely brilliant stuff. I hope these jokers are looking at it and, you know, in all ways adhere to it. I wish when we started our career, somebody showed us this, sir. Gir gir ke seekhe ye hum log.
Yeah, matlab main aur kuch nahi kiya. Main to, I'll tell you, isme mera bhi swarth hai. As I always say, human gene is most selfish and we Hindus are most. So from a pure perspective, main ye kyun bana raha hu? Main mere liye bana raha hu. कि भाई मेरे को अगर 30 साल में ये नहीं समझा है तो मैं क्या आगे लेके जाऊंगा या मैं मेरी नेक्स्ट जनरेशन को क्या दूंगा. इज वेयर आई हैव टेकन दिस एज एन अपॉर्चुनिटी
फॉर द वंस ऑन द सेशन राइट नाउ. यू नो इट्स एन एब्सोल्यूट कस्टमाइज्ड प्रेजेंटेशन एंड यू जस्ट थैंकफुल इनफ. यू नो सम ऑफ दीस वर्ड्स जस्ट स्टे विद यू. यू हैव नो क्लूज व्हाट दिस मींस एंड यू नो दिस इज दैट 30 इयर्स ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस ऑल कमिंग इन एंड पोरिंग इन टुगेदर फॉर यू सर. आई एम वेरी इंप्रेस्ड. थैंक यू वेरी मच सर. Even if these guys walk out with Thank this you, one sir. slide yes, alone, it really means a lot, sir. Oh, amazing slide.
ये सब आपकी देन है सर. आपने मेरे को opportunity दिया है तो मेरे को I have to मतलब you have given me the pitch and I have got a full toss. I have to hit it for us.
Thank you very much. Sorry for interrupting. Sir.
Thank you, sir. Yeah. नहीं नहीं no problems. Yeah, next one. So, जिंदगी में ना चार एक्सेस पे इंसान काम करता है. पहला है फिजिकल, दूसरा है मटेरियल, तीसरा है इमोशनल. एंड हुएवर हैड द क्वेश्चन, इफ यू गो थ्रू दिस इमोशनल यू नो पिक्चर, यू विल रियलाइज इट इज फुल ऑफ हाउ यू मोटिवेट योरसेल्फ, हाउ यू कंडक्ट योरसेल्फ सोशली, हाउ यू डेवलप एम्पथी टू यू नो योर ओन वर्ल्ड एज वेल एज आउटसाइड वर्ल्ड, how you regulate yourself, some of those value systems which we discussed, and how you are self-aware. See, as I said, God has made life an opportunity. And some of these things you will evolve over a period of time. Even if you keep this at the back of your mind, it will help you because just being good on one axis is not enough. And at the same time, you cannot be good on all five axes. You just cannot be good on all five. You will have to find your own balance. To be honest, and I'm sorry if it sounds slightly more religious from an Hindu faith, but there is a concept of seven chakras which is accepted by all religions. And those seven chakras alignment of the soul to the source is the purpose for which you are here, because that's where the God, the creation will use you for the purpose for which it has sent you. So the sooner you realize all that, if you're not prepared on any one of these axes, it will not flow to you. Next one. So here are the, so you choose how you want to bat. Here are the three batsmen who are the best in today's, one more click. Yeah. Who are the best in today's times? And they are good. One is Kohli, who is technically sorted, mentally extremely volatile. On the right, you have the most chaotic batsman when it comes to technique. but mentally fully sorted. And in the middle, you have amongst the epitome of, being technically organized and mentally sorted. And I'm sure all of you would have his frame in mind when they lost the World Cup to fate more than anything else. And still, he and his team carried themselves beautifully. So these are the things to take home. You decide which way you want to bat. And somewhere as you evolve as a human being, you will realize what suits you the best. And be original version of yourself rather than trying to copy. Takes uthane hai to mental mentors jundo. Lekin unki alignment karna wo aapka kaam hai. Wo dusra aapke liye aake nahi karne wala. Next one. Now this is a very important way. Just wait. Piche. Bas. Is this an old woman or a young girl? Put it in the chat box. सब जवान लड़कों को जवान लड़की दिखती है. So they are both, right? If you see from the left, bottom left corner, you will see a old woman. If you see from the top left corner, you will see a young woman. Right? Next one. What is this? Put it in the chat box. So it's a cup and at the same time it's two faces. आप किस नजरिए से देख रहे हो उससे आप डिसाइड कर रहे हो वो क्या है. और जिनको दोनों दिख रहा है वो भी बराबर है. They are willing to look at life from both perspectives. But choice आपको करना है एंड में उसको क्या बोलने का है वो. सो जिंदगी आपको मौका देगी समझने का कौन सा क्या है वो. लेकिन आपको उस वक्त चॉइस एक ही चीज चूज करने का होगा जो उस सर्कमस्टेंसेस पे डिपेंड करेगा. थर्ड वन. इज दिस अ डक? राइट, इट्स अ डक, राइट, अ डक एंड अ रैबिट. राइट, लेफ्ट से देखोगे तो कुछ और दिखेगा, राइट से देखोगे तो कुछ और दिखेगा. नेक्स्ट वन. Wait. एक-एक करके जा. Yeah, this is an old woman, like, right, before drinks. Now you have had some 5-6 glasses. You start looking at her like this. Correct? Next one. ये क्या है? What is this? Right? Now you have got conditioned to look for two things, right? Have you realized? Earlier, if you would have seen only one picture, you would have taken just one call and said, yeah, yeah, bas. Right? The next one. Ye kya hai? So it's again a perspective. If you see left to right, tilted view, it's a horse. If you see from top to down, it's a toad. Right? Now, can you read what is coming next? What is this?
Somebody's been able to read it, put it in the chat box. Or you can speak up.
So you people can read and have experience. Next time.
Oh, sex cause bad eyes.
Great. Chalo. So the guys who could not read, they know the answer now. Okay? Next. So everyone thinks different. You have to get the context right. Eventually, life में आपको काफी बार ऐसा मिलेगा कि बहुत grey areas है, and you will be forced to take a call. And if you are not willing to take a call, people will not take you with you. At that time, you have to understand the context and take a call. You may go wrong, but you have to take a call. Right? Next one. How do you define success? These are pictures of success, right? You can relate. The first one is a bronze medal. The second one is the silver medal. The first one is the gold medal. But if you ask the bronze medalist, how will she look at life? She will say, boss, mera silver chala gaya. Jo silver mila hai, wo bolega, mera gold chala gaya. So perspective hai. उस वक्त आप एब्सोल्यूट में जिंदगी को कैसे देख रहे हो और रिलेटिव में जिंदगी को कैसे देख रहे हो, वो डिसाइड करेगा आपको कौन सी फीलिंग्स और कौन से लाइफ को फेस करना है. नेक्स्ट वन. सो हाउ डू यू डिफाइन सक्सेस? वेट, एक एक करके. वेल्थ ऑफ वॉरेन बफे, राइट? फिजिक ऑफ श्वार्ज़नेगर, इंटेलिजेंस ऑफ आइंस्टाइन, बिजनेस प्रोवेस ऑफ जैक मा, creativity of Steve Jobs, imagination of Walt Disney, beauty of Madhubala, हम लोग थोड़े बुड्ढे लोग हैं, heart of Mother Teresa, grace of Amitabh Bachchan, and energy of Virat Kohli. That's how you will call success, right? Each of this axis is different. You can't get all. But if you choose your axis correctly, you know what you have to work on. So your job in that purpose is to realize what matters to you and work on that axis and see to it that the other things get balanced to do that work better. Next one. How does success look? One more. Success looks something like this and failure looks something like this. Yeah. Continue. But see them together. What comes to you? There are four parts of a circle, like, or a sine wave, right? So, जिंदगी एक चक्कर है और जिंदगी एक अप एंड डाउन का पूरा एक श्रृंखला है. सो अगर आप इस चेन को समझो तो आपके आपको क्लैरिटी होना चाहिए कि इस वक्त अगर आप चक्के के ऊपर के एज पे हो तो आप कभी भी नीचे आ सकते हो, नीचे हो तो कभी भी ऊपर जा सकते हो. सो नो टाइम्स रिमेन सेम. Please understand that. And which is where staying put, which we discussed yesterday, putting time into yourself, improving yourself, and being ready for your good times for the opportunities is what is in your hand. Yeah? Next one. What does success bring? You know, it brings happiness. And this is the same man, right? You have seen him changing England's fortune, and about a year back before that he was in dumps. But you see how life actually gives you both the things about, you know, in a span of short time based on how you handle it. So success brings happiness, confidence, harmony, health. Failure builds sadness, self-doubt, relationships issues and ailments. But simultaneously look at what success also causes. Yeah? It risks you being lazy, arrogant, complacent, self-centered. Actually, it brings the worst out of you if you are not aware. So which is where you have to build self-awareness, that emotional quotient which you are talking about. Be aware where you are at every point in time. And simultaneously, failure can result into creating a better resolve, a higher discipline, being humble and high on efforts. It brings the best out of you. It's about how you approach each of them. You have to do exactly opposite of what we have written here. So the moment you are successful, you go to the other side to say that, boss, this is something which has come to me. It's a treasure. I should work on it even more to enhance on it. Next one. So these were the three idols in 2008. Just wait. First one is Oscar Pistorius, who was a winner of Paralympics. Second was Tiger Woods, the best S golfer ever produced. And third one is Lance Armstrong, which used to be a case study in endurance, where he had won the Tour de France 6 times in a row. But these were the idols in 2008. What happened? Pistorius is in jail for killing his girlfriend. Tiger Woods has lost his family because he cheated on his wife. And Lance Armstrong is a case in point where of mass cheating of people in terms of creating a false framework based on drugs to create that, the endurance positioning. So what does this teach us? This teaches us choose your idols very, very consciously, very, very carefully. You may be shaken in your basics if your idol cheats on you. Similarly, so many people would be idolizing you as you grow in life, personally, professionally, relationship-wise. You have to be honest to that position when you come across each of these guys. Next one. Which is what brings me to the near close of what we have been doing. Everybody is talking of crisis. This is a Chinese symbol for crisis. The first one highlights the danger, which all of us are giving, which is the natural response of the survival tactics. But let's change the mindset and look at it with a mastermind of trying to create an opportunity out of it and invest in ourselves to be ready for our better tomorrow. That's how we'll have to look at life. Next one. So life is a bank which is giving us 86,400 seconds every day. It carries no balance from day to day. Whatever happens during the day, you are owning it. Wait. If you want to value a year, ask a student who has failed. A month to a mother who has given birth to a premature baby. A week for a weekly newspaper editor. An hour for lovers who are waiting to meet. A minute for a person who just missed a train. There are instances where people took a wrong train and became superstar in India. And there are instances where person missed a train in New York and got saved from the 9/11. So you have to understand what time actually does to you. 1 second for somebody who avoided an accident and 1 millisecond for somebody who just lost or who just won a silver medal. Basically, quote unquote, lost a gold medal at Olympics. Time waits for no one. Now is the moment. The equation of success is time plus money plus energy, which is the positiveness and the action that you take will create your life. Yeah, continue. It is a time bank of life. Time of the day is same for everyone. Next one. For everyone who is managing his country, state, company, house, or even life. Sabke paas 24 ghante hi hai. Focus on your return on time invested. Waqt wapas nahi aane wala hai. Zindagi mein, agar aap assume karte ho ki aap mota moti 75 saal jeene wale ho, to aapke paas 900 mahine hai. Aur un 900 mahine mein se 1/3 life aapka chala gaya hai, aadhe se zyada mera chala gaya. Or if you have to look at it, there are 52 weekends every year. Take your remaining life and you have to make those weekends worth. So invest every minute that you spend on. Prioritize your things towards those 5 stages which we discussed of career in terms of where they are taking you in terms of value addition. You will not repent in terms of value life throws at you. Next one. Use it to the maximum. Some parental counsel, and some of you guys who have done my last year's course know this. This I share always. Nobody knows the future. No one is perfect. You are unique. Create your own life. Invest your strength. Work on weaknesses. Forget if they are too weak. Have a hobby. Look for a mentor. Play at least one sport. Read. And I think this is something which your generation has to do. Read, read, and read. Respect elders, seek knowledge, aim wisdom, stay healthy and live with simplicity. Yesterday is history, tomorrow is mystery, today is gift. That's why it's called present. Live, make it the most now. Yeah, next one. With that, I thank you. जैसे रणछोड़ दास बोल के गया, काबिल बनो, काबिल, कामयाबी तो साली झक मार के पीछे आ जाएगी. All the best.